In him was life, and that life was the light of all humankind. For as the Father has given life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. The Spirit gives life. The flesh counts for nothing. The words I have spoken to you, they are full of the Spirit and life.
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 Life, life, life. What is life?
When you know why you exist, when you understand the reason why God created you, the way you are, your uniqueness, then you start to live a different life. It's a game changer. When you understand why your passion is the way it is and how you can harness all that to be able to live a meaningful life, a fulfilling life, a life that is that glorifies God, a life that actually has impact, then you realize that life is enjoyable, and there's a reason why even Jesus said, I've come to give you life and to give you life in fullness. Because then when you have purpose, you live a life of fullness. You impact people, you live for a reason, you leave a legacy when you leave this world. You impact the community, the society, the city, the continent, the world. It makes a whole difference. And so part of purpose is also helping, and especially with the volunteers that you've been working with here at YFC, is helping them understand who they are, even by virtue of their personality.
According to this book, my personality type is the doer type, so I am very persistent, I am a confronter, I am work-oriented, like I focus a lot on like the work that is done and the results that are achieved from that work. My strengths are, I am very decisive, I make decisions when a problem arises, I just solve it at that time.
So before we started doing Life-Centered Living book one, actually I used to fear Nelima so much. Like I could go in her office and I was so tense. Then even before reaching at that door, I could make a short prayer like, oh God, Aki, please just make this today to be so smooth. Because every time I could go in that office and she could be like, why are you putting this amount here? Why are you having this? Why? And I was like, oh God, what should I do? So I used to feel like she's so mean. She doesn't want to help out or but now when we started doing the book from book one to book three, so we reached in session three, and there's a way, it was about how to improve relationship with the doer types. So we went through, and I came to realize actually I was the one who was having mistakes. There's some specific questions that I was supposed just to ask, and then also I was to provide an alternative ideas and choices, and also disagree with facts. So now I could go in that office when I know what I'm going to do, and this is how it's supposed to be done, and this, I have facts with me, I have everything with me, and there our relationship became well. Nowadays I go in that office smiling. Yay!
We are blessed to have rich materials and resources such as Life-Centered Living, written by Larry Neimeyer, which talks about life. The human life and the godly life. The human life is the life that is given by human beings, born out of your parents. That's the human life. And the life that is Zoe, that it comes from God, the Spirit, where we get the Spirit after salvation. And in this book, it has really been a good resource, since we have learned how to relate in human life, personality, knowing our personality, knowing how we relate with each other.
So from going to the Life-Centered Living book one, I realized that I am the social personality, which means I'm a very relational person, which means I'm also very enthusiastic, emotional, and empathetic to others. This has really helped me being a global volunteer in Kenya because I didn't know much about the culture before I came. And so being able to make friends easier or understand others and kind of understand where they're coming from in their culture has really helped me to make deep friendships, friendships that have become really important for me to just support me in this time. But also because I'm in intercultural studies in my degree program, it just means that I can connect to others better. And so going through this book has really helped me to understand why I'm doing well or why I'm making friendships really good. Yeah.
We are getting to know how to relate with each other in the workplace. Spiritually and interrelationally.
So your uniqueness is like your fingerprints, and when people understand how different and how unique God has created them, even your spiritual gifts, then it makes all the difference to know that there's something that you as a person, as an individual, you are supposed to do. And whatever God created you to do, nobody else can do it the way. Not that nobody can do it, other people can do it, but there's a touch of your print that is unique to who you are, that is unique to how God created you, that is unique to the environment that you are in. And so putting all this together and being able to know that my fingerprints, my life of purpose is like my fingerprints, it makes all the difference. And so being part of this program with Life Center Living and with the volunteers, and being able to talk about purpose and being able to see how we can package that to allow them know who they are, to allow them to see that they're unique in the way that God created them, then for me it fulfills my heart to know that we are raising a generation that one day will make a difference in the world because they know who they are, because they have discovered their purpose and they know why they exist. And so it's something I would really encourage many young people to engage in, to discover the reason why they exist. Might be wondering what have we been using for our discipleship program or classes, and we've had amazing, fantastic materials that we've been using for this. They're called Life-Centered Living, and this book 1, 2, and 3. In book 1, just like you can see, the one I'm holding here is My Life Designed for God's Life. It's an amazing book. I know previously I talked about purpose. If you want to know about your purpose and why you exist, these are some of the materials we've been using. So this book 1, and then also there is book 2 that we've been using, still with life centered living, knowing God and his life, and also this book 3. Yeah, I know, life centered living book 3, life in life relationships. You might be out there, you might be wondering about relationships and how God gets involved in your life, and whether God cares about the relationships that you get involved in, and how do you go about your relationships. And so book 3 is all about relationships, and I can guarantee you that if you go through this book, your life will never be the same in the area of relationships. And book 4, still life-centered living, that talks about life in life ways. And so I would really want to encourage you to be part of this discipleship program, because the materials are fantastic. And maybe you're wondering, where did this come from? We have an amazing person who's been able to put these materials together. And I just want to say a big, big thank you to the person who has been behind the discipleship materials, Dr. Larry. As you can see, he has a couple of books that he has written, and the Harvesters Ministries for the support. And we are so grateful that God has
you've allowed God to use you to be able to put amazing materials that can help young people to make a difference. I mean, purpose, relationships, how you live your life. These are some of the things, some of the questions that many young people get to wonder about. And so these materials have been amazing in helping the volunteers, the young people, on how to navigate through life. And so a big shout out to Dr. Larry for the good work that you've done through these materials. And so thank you.